After discussing the protein in human milk fortifiers, we are moving to the amino acids. Here are my disclosures, and I will discuss the present situation with human milk fortifiers. I will discuss the actual versus the advisable intakes of amino acids with fortified human milk. Finally, I will address, do we have the right amino acid mix? And then the conclusions, what we can do better in the future. So first, the present situation. The best solution, as we have heard, is human milk, milk of the own mother or banked human milk, which needs to be fortified with human milk fortifier to achieve the recommended protein, energy, and micronutrient intakes of all segments of low birth with infants. Surprisingly, nothing is in the literature, evidence-based, about the protein quality in human milk formulas. So, for example, the best fitting amino acid profile, you cannot find anything. In human milk formulas from all companies, the amino acid mix is close to the amino acid mix in human milk, which is the gold standard for term infants. But for an extremely low birth weight infant with 500 grams growing more than two times faster than a term infant, is this still the gold standard? If you look at amino acid absorption, the protein is broken down into peptides and then amino acids, and small peptides and amino acids are absorbed, and then they serve as building blocks of new protein. And all amino acids have to be there, otherwise this pyramid cannot be built in a proper way. We have data from two recent studies which measured protein concentration in human milk provided to very low birth weight and low birth weight infants. And the authors said that delivering 1.4 to 1.8 grams of human milk fortifier protein with 100 milliliters of milk might be still not sufficient. The authors speculate that the amino acid profiles of the human milk fortifiers, which are close to human milk, are not perfect. And in May 2021, evidence-based guidelines are published by Fenton and co-workers, and they indicate no recommendation can be made on the quality of protein in human milk fortifiers, because there are no studies in the literature. And an extremely low birth weight infant with a birth weight of 500 grams or even below, this very small one can, after a period of adaptation with parental nutrition, can grow like the fetus. So the enteral nutrition is a challenge to be provide all the amino acids. And again, as I've said, all cow's milk-based human milk fortifiers on the market try to copy the amino acid profile in human milk by spiking with amino acids. So, for example, whey proteins, casein proteins, if hydrolyzed or intact, are spiked with human milk with amino acids. And if we have human milk protein-based fortifiers, they of course reflect the pattern in term human milk. Is this all okay? Is this the best solution? So we move to the next point, the actual versus advisable intakes with fortified human milks as far as amino acids are concerned. There are data in the literature of amino acid increments fetal gains as basis for advisable intakes. So the fetuses were chemically analyzed and the protein and the amino acid content in the carcass was measured. And from this, we took the data set, we reanalyzed the data and calculated the amino acid gains of the fetus between 0.4 and 3 kilograms. We know that this is not the perfect reference, but it's the only one we have. Otherwise, we have none. This is the way how we present the gain. This is the body weight, and this is the gain of the essential amino acids per kilogram body weight and day. And you can see very high gains at the beginning, during for extremely low birth weight infants, high gains of very low birth weight infants, and they are 87% and 37% higher than the gain between 2.5 and 3 kilograms. So this is a challenge. The same for conditionally essential and non-essential amino acids. Exactly the same patterns, very high gains of extremely low birth weight infants and high gains of very low birth weight infants. So how did we arrive from fetal gains, from fetal increments of amino acids to advisable intakes, what should be offered with enteral nutrition? We took the fetal gains data and added to the gains correction for absorption, correction for losses from the body, corrections for oxidation. We know that amino acids, to a certain extent, are used as energy source, and corrections for variations of amino acid in term human milk. And with all this correction, we arrived at a certain advisable intake, which could be a reference. And we compared this reference with the actual amino acid intakes during enteral nutrition. And we assumed that the infant received 4 grams of amino acids from human milk protein. So from human milk and from a fortifier, which has this same amino acid composition like human milk, per kilogram body weight and day. And when we compare actual intake with advisable intake, we can see that the extremely low birth weight infant between 0.4 and 0.9 kilograms has a slightly lower amino acid intake, essential amino acid intake than recommended, which results in a cumulative deficit of intake of 3.6 grams during a 3 weeks period. When we look at the very low birth weight, the data are okay, we're in a positive range. So the extremely low birth weight infant is a little bit of a problem. And we can conclude extremely low birth weight and very low birth weight infants have much higher amino acid requirements than low birth weights. Birth with infants for growth, development, and long-term health. Intake of 4 grams human milk protein per kilogram body weight and day. The quantitative amino acid intakes of extremely low birth weight infants are marginal. The quantitative intakes of very low birth weight and low birth weight infants should be okay. And then we ask ourselves, do we have the right amino acid mix? Are we providing all amino acids in sufficient amounts? And here, to understand this, we have to compare the percentage of amino acids which are needed for fetal increment. So for fetal increment, 20% of leucine is needed, 19% of lysine. And we compared this with the percentage in human milk, in term human milk, and we can see that in human milk there's an excess of isoleucine and leucine, but there are four amino acids which are lower than is needed during fetal gain: lysine, methionine, phenylalanine, and histidine. And there might be a problem with the intake. And indeed, when we look at the intake of amino acids, the differences between advisable intake, here is the line, and the actual intakes indicated by the bars. The red bars is the extremely low birth weight infant. The orange bar is the very low birth weight infant. We can see there's a problem with those four essential amino acids. And there's even a bigger problem with two conditionally essential amino acids, like glycine and arginine. And as all these infants have clearly defined roles in protein synthesis, all essential amino acids are important for protein synthesis. There might be a problem if we don't offer sufficient supply. But there might be also a problem created by the low supply in glycine, because glycine helps to protect from oxidative injury, and arginine is a growth stimulating amino acid, and it has been shown that low arginine levels in plasma are associated with higher NAC prevalence. I show you the lysine again. This is the weight. This is the advisable intake. This is the fetal gain. And this is what we provide with 4 grams human milk protein. We are far below the advisable intake, between 0.5 and 1 kilograms. We are still below weight within 1 and 1.5 kilograms. And we reach the advisable intake only between 1.5 and 2 kilograms. And the reason is, in human milk protein, there's a lower percentage of leucine as part of the essential amino acids than is needed during fetal gain. So we can say here, advisable intakes based on amino acid gains of some amino acids are higher than the actual intakes, which are provided with 4 grams per kilogram body weight and day with human milk protein. Certain amino acids, therefore, might become limiting for growth. If one amino acid is limiting for growth, the others are increasingly oxidized and used as energy source. And we must say the amino acid profile of human milk is probably not the gold standard for the amino acid profile in human milk fortifiers. So what are the conclusions, what to do? There's a mismatch between the amino acid mix in fortified human milk and the advisable intakes based on fetal gain. Therefore, in extremely low birth weight and very low birth weight infants, the actual intake of some amino acids is too low. Human milk-based and cow's milk-based fortifier proteins should be spiked with those amino acids which are undersupplied during enteral nutrition, and as example I showed, lysine, and might become limiting for growth and development. Clinical studies are necessary with improved amino acid mix in human milk fortifiers to prove this concept. And with this, I come to the end. Thank you very much for listening, and I would be happy to take your questions. Finally, I thank for the collaboration from Hans von Gaudewa from Amsterdam, Nadia Hayden from Vienna, Dominic Gradwall from Lausanne. Thank you very much.